Good morning. It's Sunday morning. This is Joanne at Journaling Adventures. And I had a couple people ask me to please show them the inside of my music journal that I just made for my brother. So I thought I would go over that real quick. And I know that y'all are probably saying, you know, does she always wear that robe? But my most productive time is early in the morning, like it's like 7 o'clock in the morning, is my most productive time. So I'm still in my jammies and my robe, and then later I get to other things. But this is my music journal that I made for my brother. I actually used a music bag from a store from the 1980s. This is it's just a bag. Just a bag when you purchase something at a music store. And I collaged the front. And this is a button that I had stamped a while back with music stamp on it. And this is the back. It's all collaged. And then I also sewed around the edges. What's nice about this bag is there are two sections in the top to store things. So I put little notepads and things in those. And the front page, this is a coffee dyed cupcake liner that I'd seen somewhere, that I decorated. And in here is a note from the bookmaker. If you go to the Paper Outpost channel and sign up for her newsletter, she has a note from the bookmaker that is really, really great. And you can, you know, revise it as much as you would like. This one right here is the cover of a very old piano book. That I've used the, it's a music book, the children's music book, Noah's Ark. And then you turn the page and I have a little pocket here that I sewed on that's collaged and with some tags in there. I left a lot of blank pages. This is for a guy. This is old music paper. I have a lot of it in here with, and you can actually see where people have circled things and drawn pictures as they were learning, and I love that. This is a little pocket I made. This is one of the cards from the 52 challenge that I'm doing, and I'm putting that in there, and then also a journaling card that I made that I decoupaged, so I put that in there. More of the old music paper, which I love. Made a little flip up where he can write there, and then another little journaling card right there. Just paper, coffee dyed music paper. A little bit of crinkle, gotta have some crinkle. This is another pocket that I made. Why is that? I guess it's just not very strong. I think I made that out of vellum and stamped it with music. And I've had this for a while in my stash. And some more crinkle music page. And this is a little pocket I made with a little dangle that I made, and then a couple tags. This is a little flip-up booklet for him to write on. And see, here's more of where this child drew a guitar and some different things. Obviously was learning at the time in doodling, and I just love that. This is just a little page to write on, but this coffee he sent us for Christmas, so I took the top off of the coffee box. More pages of somebody in a class made a little flip down place to write. This is old tobacco paper, and I think that I told you in the past videos, if you've watched any of the others, that an older lady at a craft show told me she had rolls of these receipts from when her husband or somebody had a tobacco farm. So I made a little pocket and tag out of that. And there's the other side of the Noah's Ark music book. And then I made a little envelope back here. And these are, if you look at my past videos, these are buttons I made out of corrugated cardboard. And there's the end. So that's, and it closes with this twine. It's simple. But I wanted to send him one because I'm sending his wife this one, and I've already been through this one, but I'm real excited about this dangle. Y'all look at that dangle, how perfect that is. That beaded dangle that a lady on my, one of the Facebook pages that I'm a member of sold me this, and it's just beautiful. That's one area that I've not gotten into is any jewelry or dangles or anything like that. But this one is pretty much ready to go. So both of these will go to my sister-in-law and my brother. The other thing that I did recently is I took these just regular envelopes and folded the envelope up, and then, you know, just I stained it on the front, and then did napkins on there and made a little pocket. I have not finished doing what I want to do to them. Sewed around the edges. Here's the other one. You know, a nice little pocket sewed around the edges. But that's what I've been doing. The other thing that I'm doing that's kind of new is I've never made an altered book per se, but I got this Reader's Digest, and I'm following 49 dragonflies. But we went through every so many pages. You tear out 8, and then you make a pocket. Like this one's a pocket right here too. And so every page that's left is some kind of pocket. It went from a very large book to not very many pages. Here's one page that I've already decorated. And then, you know, it's got a pocket next to it. I hope you can see all of this. And then here's another page that I've already done. So I'll go through, you know, each one of them has either, like this is a pocket. I decorated this page already. This is a pocket. They're all pockets now, and that's left. So it's gone from a page that was very, very thick to this. And I'll do it at my leisure. That's what I love about this one. It's when I feel like it, I might paint in it. There's no telling what I'll do in it. And then I'll decide what I want to do to the cover. So, excuse me, I'm still getting over this sinus. But anyway, I'm real excited about this. I've always wanted to do a real altered book. I have some other really old books that I can't figure out exactly what I'm going to do yet with those. But anyway, that's what I've been doing lately. And I made some more washi tape this morning. And waiting on some more of the 52 card challenge. She told me that there were going to be a couple more this week, so I'll be doing that. But just wanted to check in, show you what's going on, and be able to show the music book for a couple folks. Thank you, y'all. See you later. Bye.